showing you on how we do, and we did animations on these pictures, that is the car pictures, so that they'd be moving from one point to another. You see, I have called them cars, that is Toyota car, which I've just called it car race. Bye-bye. These are Toyota, these are Isuzu, these are Subaru, these are Mazda. Then I demonstrated that when you click start the race, you can see them moving. You can see them moving. Yes. Here is they move. Yeah. So all this is animations. Now I want to show you, if I open a new, workbook, then I can call it car type. Then I call this one speed, the speed of the car. Then I call this one speed support. Then I call this one the speed support, and then I call it the size of the car. Like all this I'll be giving them in terms of percentage. Like I can talk about 20%. If I talk about 20%, that means all the car size, let me use 30%. The car size, all of them will be 30%, half of them. Yes, up to that point. And then I give some speed here in terms of percentage. Like I had said, this is a Toyota. I have an Isuzu. I have Subaru. I have Mazda. So I can talk about the speed in terms of percentage. Like this one is 80%. I can also talk about like 40%. Can talk about 20%. And 20%. I can also talk about here. I give it like 100%. Now, after doing that, all these, the support speed I use the same, I just duplicate. Then I need to create a chart. I'll be using a chart. I have to use a chart. I'll not use this. I'll also use this and this. Then I go to insert. I want to insert a budget. I want to insert this type of chart. Then after inserting, what I do here, I have to come to the axis, right click, format axis. It should be the axis, not the chart area. This axis, format axis. Then categories in reverse order, because remember my order is Toyota on that, so this one it should be from this side. So I talk about categories in reverse order. You see it has reversed. Then I have to close there. Then I need to come here and also format access here. so that I give this one, I can give 0.0, the same, but I need it to give me reset. Like I can change this one to 1.7. Yes, so I need to also to change this one to 0.4. That one can retain, and then this one ensure it is 0.0 minimum, so that it will be coming to the end here. And here the maximum it can go to is up to 1.7, because 1.7 is the percentage. Remember, here I'm talking about the highest here is 120. 120, you add this one is 150, so I have added some to reach 170. To reach 170. So after that, after I'm done with all this reset, I'll have to, now I can cancel here. Then the next thing I have to do here is, if you go here, I need to remove the legend, I remove the grid. I can main with the chat and yes, I can main with that. Now I need to delete this one. I need to delete this access. Yes, right click, delete, so that I'm done now with them. Now I need to right click on this blue, on the blue, so that I format data series. I have to give this one 50. Make sure you give it 50, 50%. And then if I check, you click here, I click fill. I want to fill this color, that is gradient fill. You see, I need now to give a color like if I give like that, and then I come and give like white. White is there. Yeah. Yes, and then I'll have to select the direction where it will be moving to the right. So I'll have to select the direction it will be moving to the right. That is, this one is linear. I mean, this one is linear, but the direction here, I pick this, the second one, linear right. It is linear to the right. You check it, then you make sure you give it an angle of 180. An angle of 180. That is 180. Then if I do that, bright transparency here, I need to be 50% transparent. Transparency, I can give like 50, 50% transparency. Then after I've done with that, after I'm done with that, now I'll have to insert the cars here. You just have an image of a car or the thing you want to move. I can resize this one to have it bigger. The title I just changed to car race, like I did. You can change it to whatever you want to change. Like I called it car race. So I can change the color. If I change the color, if I change that color, yes. And then now I need to have an image of a car here that I've resized to 30 that will fit exactly here. So if I go, I can even copy this one. I can just copy this one. Okay, let me copy another one that I have here. Okay. Okay, let me get the one that I can be able to copy. I can get one. I'm able to copy. I'm able to copy on here. Now I copy this copy. Then I'll have to go to the animation I'm trying to do. This one, you click on this just one, you press Control V, you shall have pasted the cars to all the four. Then after that, now I am done, I'm ready to go and do the. I'm ready to do. Now you can remove the grid here. You can remove the grid at this point. You can go home, or I mean view, and then you can. While highlighted view, the grid lines is not. It's not activated. It's okay. Now you are now good to go and do the format. You do what we call the coding. Now you click on developer. You have your Visual Basic. Now I'm dealing with sheet one. Remember, I'm dealing with sheet one. Sheet one, I am dealing with this. This is sheet one. So when I go back to developer, I go back to developer here. I have to open this sheet one. This is another code. No, sheet one. I need to have on this sheet one. This one is giving me the one already existing. Now, if I have to, let me see. Yeah, this is the one. That is the new project. It was supposed to appear here. Now, on that new project, you start now writing the. You start writing your work. So first of all, we need to change this one to worksheet, and then here you must make it as change, so that you delete now this one. You delete this one. If I delete this one, now you should be having here. You create a space. I want to start with I'll be doing some two coding. One, some two sub procedure. So the first one is to make that car be moving. So I'll start with the dim sh. I'll talk about the dim sh as worksheet, as worksheet, as worksheet. So dim sh as worksheet. Then let me use even if I use sh as such, or I use sh, it still is okay. Then I also need to set. I need to set sh to be equal to sh to be equal to this workbook dot sheets. That is this workbook. This work book dot sheets. This workbook dot sheets. Then I have to quote the sheet that I'm dealing with is sheet one. That is in bracket. That is in quotes. We are talking about sheet one. I close the quotes, then I close the bracket. So then from there, I also need to, after setting this workbook dot sheet as sheet one, then I also need to dim I as integer, because I'll be using I. So we talk about dim I. I need to, this is a dim I as integer. I'm just declaring the variables dim I as the integer, as integer. as integer. Then from there, I need now to start now the coding. I talk about if target column 2, remember my column was 2, I'm talking about here, I'm talking about this column 2, it's what I'm dealing with. So this column 2, this is what I will be changing this column 2. So that this is just a support, I'll be dealing with this one, that's what I'll be changing. So if I change this one, it's the one that will be making it move. So if target, there is, we talk about if target column dot column equals to 2, then if target dot column, if target dot column equals to 2, then we should be, then if target dot row is greater than 1, then if target dot row equals to, if target dot row is greater than 1, meaning that it must be greater than 1 because I am dealing with width from row 2 up to row 5. So the row must be greater than 1 because 1 is just the titles. So that is why I'm saying if target dot row is greater than 1, then we say is greater than 1, and target dot row is less or equal to 5, like I've told you. And so we say and target dot row, and target dot row is less or equal to 5. And then less or equal to 5. Let me see where the problem is. I think I gave a lot of space. Is less or equal to 5? Let me see. Is less or equal to 5. Let me give a space here and see what that is the problem is. If target dot row is greater than 1, and target dot row is less or equal to 5, then is less or equal to 5, it should be that is less or equal to 5, then let me write, sometimes it can misbehave. I should not be writing the term is. Dot row is less, so just write is less or equal to 5, or equal to 5. Then is was confusing. Yes, you should not be writing is, because dot row, we know it is, that is, I'm saying is less than or equal to 5. Like here I was saying is equal to, so I shall not write to the word is. So is less or equal to 5, then we say then for i, because now I'm dealing with i, then for i equals to 0 to sheet as to sh.range, then I give that range as sh.range, then I give the range in quotes, I'm talking about b, cross the quotes. Now B and target dot row, B and target dot row, and B and target dot row, and target dot row. You cross that bracket dot value, then times 100. So it will be multiplying by 100 times 100. Then times 100. So we talk about times 100. Then we also have. After you're done with that, you talk about now that one will be multiplying by 100. We need to go to VBA do event, so that it, what shall it be doing? VBA do event. So VBA dot do event. So VBA dot do event. It will be doing. SH dot range, SH dot range. You give in C because we are dealing with column C. Shift. I also need to have the quote that is C. Then and. Target dot row, and so we should be having and target dot row and target dot row dot value dot value dot value that will be equal to. That will be equal to, so we talk about that will be equal to 1/100. Then we talk about next because we used for, so we talk about we close the for loop. We talk about next i. Talk about next i. Then we also give if dot range is that is now the range. I can copy this for when they are going to be equal, so that it will be the support speed and the speed when they are equal. That is when it must run. If they are not equal, it will not move. So I talk about if I pick for B, here dot value copy. I need to open that bracket. Is not equal to, when it is not equal to a dot value. Dot value. When it is not equal to, that is when it is not equal to, and it's not equal to. That one for C dot value, when it is not equal to the one for C, I also need to copy this one. When they are not equal, then Then that means if they are not equal, then they should be equal. Then so it will tell you they are not equal. You make sure they are equal. Make sure they are equal. So if I copy that, I place it here, control V. Then now we say equal here. Here we say equal, then they are equal. And then from there, now we talk about C. It is C that is going to be equal to B. Yes, then from there we need to end the ifs. We have done three ifs, so we end if. And if, and if, and end if. So after ending if, debug after you end the if. If I debug here, if I debug, I need to see if I debug, compile, you can see there is no error. And therefore meaning that if I run this code, you can, the best way to do it is you just go and then yeah, I can try to change, like if I change to 100, if I change to 100, you see it is moving. I change to 100 and you've seen it moving. If I change to this one, to another one, like 120 for instance, you can see it moving. It has moved. That's when I changed to 12. But if I change it to 58, you see it is moving. So that is it. Then now I can continue with whatever I was doing. I go back to my code. Now I need to activate a sheet. That is another sheet that I need to activate a sheet such that when you click on the sheet, when you open the sheet, the cars start moving. So I can activate that before I do the pattern, or I go to the pattern first. So for the pattern I'll be using, let me do the pattern so I can move. I can do that. I create a pattern developer. Now I need to insert what we call a command pattern. So if I take a command pattern there, let it remain as command one as it is. So if I double click, it has opened me here on the command. So that command pattern I need it to be activating the sheet. That is the work of the command pattern. That is what I want it to be doing. That is to activate the sheet for me. So what I'll do in that command pattern is that I'll ensure that when you click on the command pattern, the ranges will be changing. That is, for instance, I talk about that range. Remember, it is on B. Specific cell that I usually change, you see, like I tried to change, let me show you. Like I tried to change here, this is a, no, I was supposed to change B, not C, because B and C are the ones that are equal. So if I try to change like that, you've seen it move. Like if I change this to 80, then I press enter, you can see it moving. The reason is because the developer is active. So like the next one, I change it to 120. I press enter. If I press enter, you see it has moved. I change to, now they are at the same level. They are at the same level, the two. But if I change that, you know, I cannot go beyond 170. So the only thing, remember you include this one. So if I include 130, if I put this 130, including this one, it is 170. So 130, if I put 130 there, it has changed. You see, it is ahead of the other, of this other one. So I can change this back to 90. Then I move, so you can see they are moving. So what I was saying is that I want to activate this. I go to developer design mode. I want it to begin with B2. When you change B2, the whole thing would be changing, would be moving. So that is what I want to do. So on that command, I need to say that the range, because I said it's B2. So the range I open with that bracket with quotes B2, I end the quotes, then I end the crossing brackets B2 dot select, it will be selecting dot select, it will select that B2. So if it selects B2, now if the range is selected, that is if, I use if this range is selected, if this range is selected, because it will be selecting that cell, that specific cell, if the cell is selected, then if the cell, that cell is selected, then we say then it will have to it will have to add a value. But I'm lying to the system to add a value, but I'll add the zero so that speed of mine will not change. Because if you add one, then it will be almost doubling the figure, because it's a percentage. And that means it will go beyond my range, and therefore you cannot see the movement. And therefore, I need to lie to the system that it is moving. Like, I'll say if the range, then that means active cell, the active cell dot value will be equal to active cell dot value is active cell dot value plus zero. So if I add zero, it shall not active cell dot value plus zero. So it's not, for instance, I want, now let me just, before I go to another range, before I go to another cell, I can debug this one, then the end sub is okay. Now let me try to run it, developer here. And design view, I move out of design view. Then if I click on this, it's saying that range B2 dot select end sub is okay. That one I cannot see. Private sub command button one, it is clicking yes. There is an if, so I need to end the if, and if, there is that if, yes. So now if I compile, you see there is no error. Now I can run. If I click this, yes, you can see it's moving. If I click, you can see it is triggering it to move. Now I do for all of them. So that will be. So you repeat the same for the if. You repeat the same for the ifs. So there was no need. Okay. I repeat the same for all, such that now before I end the ifs, I need to now talk about if range now B2 is selected, then range, then it will be moving to, that is if range B2, if range, that is, I can click on this, I can be using this one, let me, so that I do it faster, I copy and paste. So if range dot select, let me deal with this one, Ctrl-V, Ctrl-V. If range B2, which is dot select, then we must see range B3 dot select. Then it must select, it must go to and select B3. If it is 2 that is selected, so it must go, then it will select that 3. If it select, then it select that, there's no then again here, so it will select that. And if, so I have to repeat the if, that is, if this one B3 is selected, that is, then if range of B3, that is B3 already is selected, then it will have to display this one. Then it will have to display this one. Then it will have to display this one. Okay, let me have it in a different line. Then, good. So, I can repeat this process up to, remember, I'm going to up to B5. So, I have two more. So, I can select all these. I can select all this, I copy, then I paste them here. So the first one is done up to this point. The second one, we talk about now B3, because it's the one, if range B3 dot select, then range B4, so it has to select B4. Dot select, if range B4, now this is B4 dot select, then it is that. So I still paste, I have to finish it before I, if now I'm dealing with before, if before dot select, then range B5, so it has to select cell B5, dot select, if range B5, that is B5 now is selected. If B5 is selected, then it has to pretend that it's adding a 0. So I need to end the ifs, and the ifs, I've done 4 ifs. So this one if ended, so I need to end 3 more. End if, I need to end if, and if, and if, and if, yeah. So if I end those ifs, then if I debug, it's okay. So that means if I go back now, all of them will be running, all of them will be running. So you see, is running. It's moving that one to move them slowly. It is moved them. It will also move. Yeah, it's moved them slowly. You see, they are moving. Yes, they are moving. So that means you can see how the movement is. This one is also moving to the end. That one is moving to the end. You see, that is how animations are good. That is how good animations are. You can see them moving slowly from one to another. So when you place a pattern, you can see them moving. You can see them moving, yes. They'll be moving up to the... Yeah, they'll just be moving slowly. You can see that moving, then it continues that way. So that is it. That is how you can do animations of cars. You can do animations of other things by using Excel. Thank you for listening. If you like this video, ensure you subscribe, share, and like it in YouTube channel so that you are able to get the next episode of Excel. Thank you for listening.